The dire appeal from the widow of slain Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo asked senators to help address what she described as the breakdown of the criminal justice system in their province. Degamo asserts the killings have been going on for years and that suspended Congressman Arnulfo Teves Jr. and his brother, former Governor Pride Henry Teves, are behind the deaths.
May problema po tayo na pag ang Teves ang kalaban natin, walang lawyer na tatanggap sa iyo. May problema po tayo sa fiskalya at sa prosecution. Minsan, ang fiskal pa mismo ang magdadala ng papel at i-encourage ka na umatras na lang. We have problems with the judges. We have to address the breakdown of the criminal justice system po in our province. Nananawagan po ako kung Governor, former Governor Henry and Arnie should be answerable to the things that they did to our province.
Also during the hearing, Seaton Mayor Fritz Diaz alleged illegal activities like online cockfighting continue in Negros Oriental. He adds law enforcers in the province receive payoffs from the Tevises.
We have evidence that napatuloy not only in Negros Oriental but in the whole country. Palipat-lipat lang sila ng lugar. Kung makaano ako ng executive session, sir, kasi kumpleto to, kaya walang nasold na killings sa Negros Oriental, sir, because of the enforcers. Not all, kasi maraming mababait. Pero karamihan sa may rank na enforcers, bayad po ng mga Teves using the gambling money.
In an interview on ANC's Head Start earlier today, Mayor Janice Degamo said she believes both Pride Henry Teves and Arnulfo Teves Jr. are involved in the killing of her husband. Degamo adds she has personal information tying the brothers to the murder.
I have a video. I might post it maybe. I-ano ko na lang talaga yun. Hindi lang si Arnulfo Teves ang hinihinalaan ng husband ko. Sabi ng husband ko, Henry Teves and Arnulfo Teves are the source of threats to his life. Mm-hmm. Bakit ko po nasabi yan? Remember, mm-hmm. my husband was governor before he died. May intel reports na pumupunta sa asawa ko. Mm-hmm. And my husband shares it to me. I have a goal. Mm-hmm. I have a goal. I do not want my husband's death to become one of the numbers lang na idadagdag doon sa hindi na solve na statistics ng mga namatay sa Negros Oriental. Mm. Sabi ko, I will grieve properly the moment I am able to do everything I know how to find my husband's justice.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa says if it was up to him, he would have allowed Congressman Teves to virtually attend their hearing. Senator De La Rosa now explains why the lack of jurisdiction over Teves is a big issue. Teves has been in hiding since he was linked to Degamo's murder.
Kung siya ay hindi magpunta sa embassy, nasa ibang bansa, the committee has no jurisdiction over him dahil wala siya sa teritoryo natin, sa Pilipinas. Any rulings coming from the committee
will be invalid.
Implemented upon him. Bago nagprotesta si Mayor Degamo, pinayagan ko siya, sige, kasi it will give us an opportunity to grill the alleged mastermind of all these killings. Gusto lang talaga ng membro ng committee na mayroon kaming jurisdiction
Senator De La Rosa adds there could be some truth to reports. Teves has organized a death squad in Negros Oriental to carry out political killings.
Possibly, and ito yung kinukonsider nila na political killings. Bakit hindi pa na-identify kung sino ang mastermind?
Mm-hmm.
Yan nga problema sa investigasyon natin. Putol tayo palagi hanggang doon lang sa mga gunman. Dahil yung mga gunman ay hindi magsasalita, hindi na in-implicate yung kanilang mastermind.
Two Philippine Army senior officials tagged in the murder of a Davao City-based businesswoman last year, set to undergo court-martial trial this week. The Philippine Army says it has finished reviewing the administrative charges against Brigadier General Jesus Durante III and Colonel Michael Licayo over their alleged involvement in the killing of Ivonette Chua Plaza. Durante and Licayo are currently detained in Campanacan in Davao City. The General Court Martial is the military's highest level trial court that is responsible for trying service members for alleged serious crimes. Philippine Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos responding to the statement of Police Chief Rodolfo Azurin, he is being misled to believe there was a cover-up in a major drug bust last year. Azurin had ruled out any attempt to whitewash the probe into the drug links of Police Sergeant Rodolfo Mayo Jr. The PNP chief asserts there are syndicates out to sow confusion and create a rift between the police and the Interior Department. But in a statement, Abalos insists the video of the anti-drug operation speaks for itself. Abalos adds the public deserves to know the truth as to what happened to the 900 kilos of drugs that were seized that day. An update now on the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro. The Philippine Coast Guard says the first phase of cleanup operations is nearly 78% complete. It's been nearly 2 months since the MT Princess Empress sank while carrying 800,000 liters of fuel.
Actually, malaki yung progress natin doon sa phase 1 na tinatawag natin. Kaya nga pumupunta na tayo doon sa monitoring. Nandun na lang tayo sa monitoring stage. And yung iba doon na napuntahan before ng langis, meron kami kasi tinatawag na nagte-pressure washing na kami. Yung mga mancha na nakadikit sa bato, nandun na tayo ngayon. Tinatanggal na namin using pressure washing. Then pinopolish din yan, yung mga bato na yon.
Meanwhile, the Coast Guard said they have yet to receive any report on the possible spread of the oil slick in Puerto Galera. This comes after Oriental Mindoro Governor Humerlito Dolor said Puerto Galera and nearby areas failed 4 consecutive water quality tests. The local government of Manila is studying the possible reimposition of the face mask mandate following a slight uptick in COVID-19 cases in the city. Manila Mayor Honey Lacuna said there are already 91 cases in the city since Monday. Most of them are experiencing mild symptoms. The LGU attributed the rise to the exodus of people during the recent long Holy Week holidays.
Kung magkakaroon po ng surge, we might opt to go back to the mandatory use of face mask. Pero wala pa naman po talagang plano sa ngayon kasi hindi naman po alarming pa yung pagtaas.